Now let us discuss block on block problem with respect to three blocks here. Here the question is, the figure shown in this is 2 case block on 3 case block, 3 case block on 7 case block, and combinedly this architecture on a smooth horizontal surface, that is what coefficient of friction he has given that 0, and the coefficient of friction between 3 case block and 7 case block, it is given that 0.3, and the coefficient of friction between 2 case and 3 case, this is 0.2. then he asked that if 10 newton force is applied in case 1 or in option A, that is applied on 2 case block, or B, if it is applied on 3 case block, and C, if it is applied on 7 case block. So if a 10 newton force is applied on each block separately, we need to find the corresponding accelerations of each block here. That is what the question here. If 10 newton force is applied on 2 case in first problem, what is the acceleration of 2 case block, and what is acceleration of 3 case block, and what is acceleration of 7 case block? We need to find these three accelerations when 10 newton force is applied on 2 case. Similarly, we need to find these three accelerations when 10 newton is applied on 3 case and 7 case. This is what the question we have. For that, first let us see this. To solve this problem, first, if combinedly one object is there with this much mass, 732, totally 12 kg mass. If a 12 kg mass getting into acceleration A because of force 10 newton, then what is the acceleration possible here? So acceleration is equal to force upon mass. So total force applied is 10 newton, and total mass it is 12 kg, so that it is 5/6 meters per second square. This much acceleration is possible because of 10 newton force on 12 kg mass. That means this total three objects to coming into combined acceleration, we need to get 5.6 meters per second square. So what is the combined acceleration means here? 5/6 meters per second square, it is combined acceleration. So if it is a combined acceleration, then a 2 case block, if it is having this much acceleration, how much force is needed to keep that 2 case block with this much acceleration, we need to find. Here I am finding that a 2 case block to getting into 5/6 acceleration, how much force is needed here. So the required force for the 2 kg mass to getting into the acceleration of 5/6 meters per second square. So for that, the force is equal to mass into combined acceleration. So mass is here 2 kg, and combined acceleration is 5/6. So that it is 5/3 or 1.6 newtons required. So there is 1.6 newtons requirement to get this 2 kg mass into 5/6 acceleration or combined acceleration. Fine. Similarly, if you find this required force for 3 kg block, how much force is required to getting into the combined acceleration 5/6 meters per second square, means it is force is equal to, this is mass 3 kg and acceleration 5/6. So 3/6, it is 1/2, 5/2, this is 2.5 newtons requirement. So with 2.5 newtons force, we can make this 3 kg block into 5/6 acceleration. Fine. And similarly, let us calculate for 7 kg block the requirement of force. For the 7 kg block, it is to get the acceleration 5/6, the force requirement, it is mass 7 into acceleration 5/6, it is 35/6 or 5.9 newtons. So this much force is required to get 7 kg block into combined acceleration. Fine. And next thing, if two objects are in contact, or two surfaces are in contact like this, observe how the friction direction we are taking at a given surface. First we have to discuss this point, how we are taking the friction direction at a given surface. There is one surface here with some coefficient of friction, first object, second object with some mass. Then friction in which direction we have to take? For example, in case 1, if force is applied on 1, force is applied on one. In that case, observe that two blocks, one and two, I have applied force on first block. Then friction in which direction we are taking means, a friction is a tangential force at the surface. That a tangential force can be either rightwards or leftwards. That we have to consider based on the applied force. So as per the definition of the friction, friction should oppose the motion of the object or relative motion of the object simply. So friction opposes the relative motion. So if the force is applied towards right side, the friction on this object should be taken left side. Fine. And here if you observe on first object and second object, the forces, if you observe applied force right side and friction force which opposes this motion is towards left side, and at the contact surface the friction, if it is leftwards for one object, on the second object it should be taken in the opposite direction. That means this is towards right side. Observe the friction force on the first object, it is leftwards, on the second object it is rightwards. Similarly, if the force is applied on second object, so same structure, on the second object if I apply force, friction in which direction we are taking, let us observe. So here on object 2, if force is applied in this direction, then the friction should be taken in the opposite direction for this object. So friction here in this direction, and then on the other object the friction should be taken in the opposite direction with respect to this one. So both are F's only here. So the contact force, the frictional force here on one object, it is in one direction. Same contact force at that the same surface, the friction direction should be in opposite direction for the other object. This is what we are observing here. And one more thing, if you observe here in this case, this friction opposes relative motion here, whereas this friction causes the motion of the second object. Observe, this friction causes the motion of the object 2. Even though there is no force applied on the object 2, because of this contact force, friction force, because of this F, this second object also getting into the motion. That is what, friction causes motion here, whereas on the object 1, friction opposes the motion, because here force applied on the object 1. So the friction should oppose that relative motion. Fine. Similarly, here also you can observe, in the second case, we applied the force on the object 2. So the contact force or friction force should oppose this applied force, or this applied force direction, opposite direction we are taking this friction force, because it should oppose the relative motion. So here it is opposing the relative motion, here it is causing the relative motion, or simply it causes the motion. On the first object it is causes the motion, on the second object it is opposes the motion, because force applied on the second object here. Fine. So let us observe these points, and then let us calculate the frictional forces given in this diagram. So there is 0.2 coefficient of friction at the first surface. So what is the frictional force F1 at this first surface? It is F1 is equal to mu1 N1. So mu1 it is 0.2. N1, if you observe at this surface, 2 case block is there, so that it is directly I can take that mg 0.2 into mass, it is only 2 case, and g value 10 let us take, so that it is totally 4 newtons friction force at the first surface, that is between 2 case block and 3 case block. Similarly, let us take second coefficient of friction 0.3, so that second friction or friction at the second surface, that is between 3 kg and 7 kg, it is 0.3 multiplied by mg, and this time observe this mass, we are taking the surface this one, that means above the surface we are combining having the mass 2 plus 3, it is 5 kg. Because of this 5 kg only normal force we have to take, so that m value here we have to take 5. So 0.3 into 5 into 10, so totally it is 15 newtons. So we got the frictional forces here, individual frictional forces at this. And one more point, if you observe here, if the applied force greater than friction force, what happens? Whereas if the applied force less than the frictional force, what happens? Friction opposes the motion, relative motion. So applied force, if it is more than the frictional force, then obviously relative motion exists. Simply, it causes relative motion. Whereas applied force, if it is less than the frictional force, that means frictional force is more than the applied force, then in that case there is no relative motion. So that we cannot take relative motion here, combined motion only possible. Relative motion not possible here. That means observe that force applied, that is less than frictional force, there is no relative motion. So we have to take that combined motion at that surface. Fine. So with respect to these observation points, let us solve each case, option A, B, C. First, let us take the option A. In this case, force is applied on the two case block. If force is applied on the two case block, how the all other frictional forces we are taking on each individual blocks, I'll show you here. Let us take combinedly like this, so that we can easily understand by comparing each case here. I am taking, while in case A, on two case block we need to take 10 newtons force. Whereas in case B, on three case block we need to take 10 newtons force. In C, on seven case block we need to take 10 newtons force. So while it is applied that particular force on this two case, what about the forces on 3 case and 7 case, we need to sort out here. Similarly, let us take here also, individual block separately I am taking for easy analysis like this. So first case, when force is applied on the 2 case block, here I am applying the force 10 newtons. Then first, at this surface 2 to 3, the frictional force should oppose this motion, relative motion R. So this is the frictional force F1 in this direction. And at the same surface, this frictional force, if it is leftwards, the frictional force on the other object should be in opposite direction, that is rightwards. Same contact force F1 in rightwards on three case block. Similarly, on three case block, because of this F1, the motion is towards the right side, then obviously this contact surface force should be opposite to this F1. So we have to take here F2 in this opposite direction. And on the second surface, if one friction force is in leftward direction, obviously it should be rightward direction for the second object, that is F2 rightwards for this 7. If you observe here 10 newton force is applied on 2 case block. There is no force applied on 3 case block and 7 case block. But there is a tendency that because of movement of this 2 case, there is a possibility to move this 3 case and 7 case block also. In which direction? Towards right side only. If this block moves right side, obviously the remaining blocks also tending to move right side. That means here, if this friction here opposes this 10 newton, this friction should cause motion of the 3 case block. Observe that this is opposing force, this is caused force, causes the motion. Same contact force for one block, it is acting in one direction, for other block it is acting in opposite direction. That means the behavior should be opposite. This is opposing the force, this is causes the motion. This is opposing the relative motion, this is causes the motion. Same frictional force, that we have to observe here. Similarly, F2, if you observe here 3 case and 7 case, 7 case is this F2 should cause the motion for 7 case block. Observe the motion always towards the right side. So the force in the right side direction should always, that is causes the motion. And the force that is leftwards, left side, that should be opposing force. That is what F2 is, opposing force for the 3 case block. Whereas F2 is on the 7 case block, it causes the motion. Fine. Similarly, let us sort out the forces for this case B. Here what happens? On 3 case block 10 newton is applied. Then frictional force, how we have to take? At this surface, this contact surface should oppose this motion, relative motion. So F1 should be here in this direction. And here what happens? Second surface is there. That surface also should oppose this 10 newtons relative motion. Because of this 10 newtons, some relative motion will be there. That relative motion should be opposed by this frictional force. So F2 also leftwards. There are two surfaces for this 3 cage block. That's why two opposing forces. That's why two frictional forces F1 and F2 in the leftward direction. Fine. If this is in the leftward direction for this 2 cage, this should be in rightwards direction, and this causes the motion. And F2 is in leftwards means for on 7 cage block, F2 should be rightward direction. That should causes the motion of 7 cage block, even though there is no external force on 2 cage and 7 cage block. Because of this frictional force, those are tending to move. There is a possibility of causing motion. Fine. And similarly, third one, if you observe, 10 Newton force is applied on 7 cage block. Then here at the contact surface, one surface is there, that one surface causing into the frictional force, that is F2 in the leftward direction. Here obviously rightward direction F2 will be there. And if this is trying to move rightwards, this contact surface frictional force should oppose that movement. That's why this force should be opposite to this F2. So this is F1, and this surface provides leftward frictional force for the 3 cage object. Means obviously on 2 cage block, the force in the opposite direction, that is rightwards. Observe here also, on 2 cage block there is no external force, but that is trying to tend to move towards right side. That's why frictional force, we should get right side. Similarly, on 3 cage block there is no external force applied. Because of 7 cage block applied force only, the frictional force which is on this 3 cage block, that trying to move this 3 cage block towards right side. Of course, there are two forces. The resultant force of these two forces, that should be towards the right direction finally. F2, F1. The resultant force, what happens? F2 minus F1. Difference of these two. F2 minus F1, that should be towards right side. Observe F2, we got that 15 Newton. Observe F1, 4 Newton. F2 minus F1, 11 Newton. In which direction? The bigger force is F2, right side. That means difference, F2 minus F1 also right side. That causes the 3 cage block move towards the right side. Verified. So we have to sort out the forces first like this. After sorting the forces like this, let us analyze clearly what happens to the acceleration of each block here. First, let us consider this one. Observe, 10 Newton force is applied on 2 cage block. If 10 Newton force is applied on 2 cage block, it is getting into the acceleration A1. Right. F1 how much? 4 Newton. F2 how much? 15 Newton. F2 is 15 Newton. Observe that. F2 15 Newton means here applied force how much? 10 Newton. Whatever the block it may be, applied force is 10 Newton applied each case. But at the contact surface 2, 15 Newton frictional force is there. That means whatever the case it may be, this frictional force, second frictional force is more than the applied force, whatever the case it may be. Because frictional force F2 is 15 Newton, but applied force it is only 10 Newton. So this case, second one, applied force less than frictional force, where at second surface. So obviously there should be combined motion for three cases at the surface 2. We no need to analyze, simply to say, we no need to analyze separately, particularly for this problem, because in this problem only it is 10 Newton force, which is less than this frictional force 15 Newton. That's why we no need to verify here 3 cage, 7 cage block, there is no relative motion. Always 3 cage, 7 cage blocks, combinedly together motion is there. A combined motion is there, a together motion is there for this much applied force. Fine. Anyhow, here 2 cage block, if it is having 4 Newton force left side, 10 Newton force right side, it is getting into acceleration A1. That means how much it is? Force 10 Newton minus 4 Newtons divided by mass 2 kg. How much we are getting? This is 6 upon 2 meters. 3 meters per second square acceleration we are getting for the first block, 2 kg block. That is acceleration A1, we got that 3. Similarly here, 3 and 7 if you observe, 3 and 7 cannot separate because they are combined motion. They are moving together. If they are moving together, totally how much mass will be there? 10 kg mass is there. If 10 kg mass, observe that, if these two are combined, we no need to take these two forces. Only F1 force will be there on combined mass 10 kg. So 10 kg mass, if force, frictional force F1, that is 4 Newtons applied, how much acceleration is possible? First of all, combined motion means here, if acceleration A2, that should be equal to acceleration A3. A2 equal to A3. In this case, A2 equal to A3, that is equal to, because of this much force, this much mass should getting into acceleration this much. That is 4 Newton divided by 10. That is 0.4 meters per second square. We are getting the combined acceleration of 3 kg and 7 kg blocks. Fine. Second case, if you observe, 10 Newton force is applied here. Fine. If 10 Newton force is applied here, what about this 2 kg and 7 kg block? Whether they move together with this 3 kg or any relative motion exists or not, that we have to verify. What we need to verify? Whether relative motion exists for 2 kg block, whether relative motion is exist for 7 kg block or not. However, 7 kg block cannot maintain relative motion, already it is confirmed. Only 2 kg block, let us verify now. 2 kg block, how much force it is having? F1. How much F1 means? 4 Newton force. For 2 kg block to move together, how much force required actually? Observe here. The required force for individual blocks I have calculated here. 1.6 Newtons is required force for 2 kg block to getting into combined motion. So, if it is to move combinedly with 3 kg block, it needs how much power? 1.6 Newtons. But it has how much power? F1, 4 Newtons. More than this required. So, minimum this much force needed to go 2 kg mass along with 3 kg mass. So, obviously F1, 4 Newtons, more than 1.6 Newton. So, it moved together. And already 3 and 7 combinedly moving. And 2 also now combinedly moving with 3. So, obviously 2, 3, 7, these 3 blocks are combinedly moving. Combined motion, acceleration we calculated in this first case, that is 5 by 6 is the combined motion. So here A1 is equal to A2 is equal to A3, that is equal to 5 by 6 meters per second square. That is verified here. And let us check here F2. So what is the required force for 7 kg block to move together? This much 5.9 force required to move 7 kg block, it combined with 3 kg block. Is there more than 5.9 Newton force on this 7 kg block? Let us verify. F2 is there na? Only F2 is there on 7 kg block. What is F2? 15 Newton. So 15 Newton force is there, but minimum 5.9 Newton only required for us for combined motion. But we have 15 Newton, more than required. That means it can go combinedly. So that is verified. Now let us come to the last case. In this last case, 10 Newton is applied on the 7 kg block. Then what happens to the combined motion of 2 kg and 3 kg? Let us verify here. Here, first if you observe, 3 kg and 7 kg block, obviously it is combined motion. We already know that. Anyhow, let us verify here also. F2, this is 15 Newton. F1, it is 4 Newton. 15 minus 4, 11 Newton towards right side. How much force required for this 3 kg block to getting into combined motion? Observe here, we calculated already 2.5 Newton minimum force needed for 3 kg block to getting into combined motion. But how much force we are having here? Because of these two forces, there is 11 Newton force towards right side. 11 Newton is there, but we need only 2.5 Newton. So 11 Newton sufficient. So 3 kg block moving combinedly with 7 kg block, that we have verified from this diagram. Of course, already observation point is there, but once again we have verified whether that can move combinedly or not. Yes, it is possible. 11 Newton force is there. Resultant force of these two frictional forces we have, that is sufficient force more than the required force 2.5 Newtons here. Fine. And what about 2 kg block? How much force it is having? F1 force towards right side. How much? 4 Newton force is there. How much force required for the 2 kg block for combined motion? That is 1.6 Newton. We need only 1.6 Newton for 2 kg block for combined motion. But we have how much force? F1 is equal to 4 Newtons. This is sufficient force to move 2 kg blocks for combined motion. Fine. So 2 kg blocks having sufficient force for combined motion and 3 kg block having sufficient force for combined motion, then obviously these 3 blocks are moving combinedly once again in this case also. So combined motion here also, A1 is equal to A2 is equal to A3, that is 5 by 6 meters per second square. like that, by sorting out the required forces in the given diagram, we can proceed the analysis like this. So before that, observe that each point we have to clearly analyze. We have to keep in mind all these points. Fine.